It's your girl Teshiamonique here, and I am just on my way to the nail shop. What else is new? But it's about 6 p.m. or 6:15 now, and I'm trying to make it there before they close at 7. I mean, of course, way before then, so I can get my pedicure done and everything before they close at 7 today. Today is a Wednesday. Just finished recording a video for you dolls, which was kind of what I'm gonna title like a update video or where have I been kind of video, because I really don't have a title for it. But I have mostly just been doing vlogs for you guys lately, which I love to vlog, and I know a lot of you guys like to see my vlogs, but then you also like to come to my channel for other specific type videos. Lots of people have commented like, all you do is vlog, or you know, is this a vlogging channel and that sort of thing. And it's not really a vlog channel, it's not really you know, a non-vlog channel. It's just a channel where, you know, I record what I want to record for you guys and share things that I think that you would find interesting. And a lot of people do like my vlogs because, you know, I do share a lot of stuff in my videos as well. So yeah, but anyways, you know, I don't think I'm gonna start like a separate vlog channel or anything like that, because I think just because my audience comes on to see me for different reasons, like some like the vlog, some don't, some like both or whatever. So it's kind of just like a hodgepodge of both. If I ever come to the point where I feel like it would be more beneficial to have a separate vlog channel, then I definitely will do that for you guys. But for right now, it's just gonna all stay as one. I know a lot of you dolls are always like, what lipstick are you wearing? Where'd you get that choker and that sort of thing? So go ahead and just check out that video. I will link it below for you guys, so that you could just click on it after you watch this one, of course, and then go and check that one out or whatever. Let me think. Another thing that a lot of people have been asking me was about my teeth. Some people had noticed, I guess, in my last vlog that my teeth are a little bit whiter, or that they're white a lot. You know, not a lot, but like people are like, wow, you have really white teeth and stuff. And thank you dolls for your comments. I love reading your comments, so make sure and leave me a comment. If you watch the video, be sure to comment, be sure to like, be sure to subscribe, that way you're tuned in for future videos and stuff like that. But yeah, my teeth, I do have a new product that I've been using, and I did record something for you dolls about my teeth whitening, I guess not system, but just what I normally do, like my technique and, you know, how I maintain my teeth and stuff like that. So I'm definitely going to get that up for you guys really, really soon. I just need to edit. Like, I have a lot of stuff that I've recorded, a lot of content, and it's just stuck like in my video or camera, and I haven't uploaded it yet, so I just need to do that. But that video will be coming soon. I'm really feeling this choker today, dolls. I am loving this, and at first I was like, blue jean, I don't know if it's kind of played out or whatever, but oh my god, I'm so feeling this. It just breaks up the like monotony between like my lip and my shirt color, because I have on like full-on like leggings that are the same color too, and it's just like a little bit of color that's a little bit different enough to where it looks good. You know, I'm just really feeling it, so I might go back and get me another one, because like I said in my other video, is that this one was only $1.50 from the beauty supply, if you could believe that. So I would like to get another one, like a backup or whatever. And also, like, because these are like $1.50, they are beauty supply, you know, they're cheap, but they're not bad quality, they're just, you know, cheap or whatever. So you can't expect like the clasp on it not to break, or one of the chains or something to break. Tomorrow I'm gonna be going with my mom to get a massage and just to hang at the spa or whatever, which I'm so excited about. I cannot wait. So I just wanted to make sure I had got my toes done, because I'm not having them done tomorrow like I usually do when I go to our spa place. For this time, I don't like my nail shape and all of that, and they messed up my nails. So the guy, the owner, who is so cool, he took off some of the money, you know, like my payment or whatever, when I get ready to check out, when I got my nails done last week, because he was like, that's not done right. We can tell that they don't look the best. So he went ahead and took some money off or whatever. So I'm not really satisfied with them. They just look kind of lumpy, and they just don't look like the shape and stuff is not right. So I did mess around and go to a different girl or whatever, because my regular lady was not available. And I mean, if you have somebody that does your nails good and that you like it, then stick with them. Don't swap out when you find you a good nail tech, because everybody does not know how to do nails just because they work at the nail salon. Trust and believe. Like, always vlogging about the nail shop, but it is what it is. On my face, can we get into this beat for a minute? Let's get into it. On my face, I am wearing Urban Decay. It's the all-nighter foundation, and I am loving it. I need to do a review on it, but I love this foundation, guys. It is so flawless. It's so seamless. It sets really good. The color match is pretty good. Once I, you know, it's a little bit light. I got the number 10, and I'm going to do a review on it because I really, really love it, and I think that you dolls would love this foundation as well. And it's supposed to work really good for oily skin is, you know, what it's really boasting for us for oily skin, and I really, really love it. So far so good. Like I said, it's the shade 10, so it's a tad bit off for me, but once I set it with like my MAC mineralized skin finish and stuff, it's good. Like, it's not that bad. I mean, as you can see, it looks good. Hold on, let me find a parking spot. It's pretty basic, but it's a good little outfit. It's the two-piece set. My top was like $4, and I think the leggings were like $7, and it's a complete fit. This is not what I usually wear with this, but yeah. So here I am, and yes, Louis on deck. I need a new bag so bad. Coconuts over OPI, and I think it's part of the Fiji collection. Okay, dolls, so I am here at the spa. I was waiting for everybody to clear out so I wouldn't look foolish vlogging at the spa with a camera. But I'm very, very chill. I love it. We're gonna have lunch here. I'm having a massage. Mom is getting a facial right now. And then I get my massage next, and then we're gonna meet up for lunch. Hi dolls, it's your girl, and I just wanted to give you outfit of the day. Yes. I'm wearing Sushi Kiss on my lips. And we are just hanging out today. I'm going to lunch with my cousin, who is going to the Air Force soon. And I don't know, I'm not feeling the Sushi Kiss on the lips. But we're gonna wear it anyways. You okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yay, Josh got a popsicle. And that's it, dolls. I'm still in love with high-waisted jeans. They just give your curves a little extra. Mwah. Kiss the buns, pull them up. And they're just really flattering, especially, you know, if you're not extra flat on the tummy area. It kind of smooths everything out there, at least in my experience. And I really, really love them. I'm wearing my shades from Five Below that were like $5, so I'm still rocking in those.
So
bothering me today because it is so delicate, but I love it, but it's so delicate. And it keeps turning around on me, so every time I go to pull it, I'm trying to be extra careful so that I don't end up breaking it. But it's so light, and it's this black net choker, and it came in a set of two, but I'm just wearing this one today. I'm rocking it with this khaki or beige t-shirt, crop top t-shirt, which I've been loving me some crop top tees lately. Let me step out so I can show y'all my full outfit of the day. And yeah, so I'm wearing this, just this crop top, and yeah, hello boo tie coming through. I'm not sticking it out, this is sticking it out, y'all. This is in. And anyways, it's just this crop top, and I'm wearing these white jeans. These are not Fashion Nova. I know you dolls are like, oh, you know, high-waisted jeans, Fashion Nova. No, these are just like a local store or something here in the Houston area. And they got a little tight on your girl, so they started busting. Like, it was just a little rip in each knee, and then they started like busting a lot. Please excuse the curves. It started busting a lot, so I ended up like, it was just like a big split like up both knees, so I ended up cutting like just this big gash out of them just to make them like that. And excuse me, I'm getting thicker than a bowl of oatmeal these days, but I'm loving it. And let's get the full. Hey. Yes. And that is it. I'm just picking up my mom. We're gonna go from there. I have this massive friend with me today, and he says hi. And I'm so ready for him to go. I've been putting everything on there. I think that is from my Clinique pore minimizing cream, because I've been putting it on here, like in my T-zone, and here, and I've got some bumps popping up there, then I had one last week there. So I'm thinking that I may not be able to do anything extra in my T-zone. I don't know, when I'm mattifying my T-zone, it's just like clogging it to where, you know, it's not letting air get through, and it's just always causing me breakouts. And that's why I had to take back that Smashbox mattifying gel. I had to take back another Clinique product that I had that was doing the same thing. So I'm just feeling like I just cannot put anything in my T-zone at all. Not any mattifiers, no pore minimizers, no nada. I'm trying to get something to just kind of minimize and blur in an area, and I can never put anything there, because as soon as I start putting stuff there, even like my Benefits, then it immediately starts to break out like right there. And I know that's what it's from, because that's such a random place, but that's where I really like concentrate on it for my pores, because they're enlarged right there. So that's how I know that that is like a breakout reaction from something I've been putting on my face. So yeah, anyways, I'm really feeling this choker. Oh, I should have filmed from this side. Look at that. Hello, I may have to refilm. Hello. And I'm just wearing like my little house shoes, looking furry slippers for the comfort. And yeah, they're ready to go. So anyways, dolls, I just wanted to give you this outfit of the day. I'm so glad I'm putting my way back on. I'm not stressed anymore. I'm living and loving life, and it shows. And I'm so glad. So I will talk to you dolls in a minute.
You want me to drive for you?
Me with my eldest grandson.
Yeah.
Spider-Man.
See that, Peter? Piper. Peter Piper. Woo, Kayla, baby. You're doing it, baby.
You got it, baby.
Hey, dolls. I am back again. It is Saturday. It is about 11 a.m. I am headed to brunch. I am calling today my Johnny Cash day, because I am in all black. And I do that sometimes. I don't know. It's really sunny and nice out, but I'm actually dressed in all black head to toe. I've got on this little black crop top, kind of halter, and these ripped up high-waisted jeans. And I will show you dolls my outfit when I get out. But I mean, you know, it's cute. I like it. It's casual to me. Some may say like, oh, it's so dressed up just to be going out for the day, or you know, for brunch or that kind of thing, but it's what I was feeling. I like to dress up, so kill me for that. I did go a little bit softer on the lips since I'm just all in stark black today. I was gonna do my Russian red on the lip, but I decided not to. And I've got, look at that breakout. Oh my God. I don't know why my face is broken out. I do know why, and we already talked about it, but now I've got an additional friend that joined the party. So just the three of us are headed to brunch currently. And I'm just wearing some silver hoops and some little flat sandals that I will show you guys. And I just got this cute little crossbody bag. It's like leather. And it's got the long strap, and I'm just wearing it across body. So I'll show you guys my outfit when I get out. And I just kind of wand curl my hair a little bit today. I'm still debating on whether I'm going to put on my red lip or not. But, yeah, it's a cute outfit. I'll show you guys, like I said. But this is just the vibe for today. I'm calling all black. I've even got my black shades that I'm going to be wearing. But I didn't want to put it on right now because my makeup is fresh. And I didn't want to get the two little indentures on my nose. But I will put those on and rock them out. My Celine style all black shades. And yeah, so I'm just headed to brunch. I'm supposed to go to the movies later and take my kiddos to see Boss Baby, which I'm excited about, and they are too. We've been looking forward to seeing that movie for some time now. And on my lips right now, I'm wearing stone and taupe mixed together, two MAC lipsticks. I have taupe on, and then I put a stone on top of it. But I think I may put on my red lip a little bit later is what I'm planning to do, just to kind of have a little color going on. And yeah. If I can catch a mirror, then I can show you Doss what I'm wearing today. Here I am, fat stomach and all. Wait, how do I do this? I'm gonna be able to get the front. But... all right, dolls, I'm coming back on today. I just wanted to show you guys my makeup. This is really the first time I've worn the Urban Decay all-nighter, like when it's been hot out, because it's been like winter and everything, so it's been a little bit milder. But today I was kind of out and about and walking around in like a little shopping area here, and it's giving me a little oil, as you dolls can see, but I've had it on all morning. And I'm getting a little bit of shine from it to where I'm having to, you know, blot or whatever. But I just wanted to say that it is wearing a little bit oily. And for this to be the Urban Decay all-nighter specifically, like mattifying it for oily skin, I thought that it would wear a little bit more, like, without a shine. So, anyways, that is my feedback on this makeup so far. So, I'm not sure how it will do for the summer months. Once it starts to really get hot, especially here in Texas, I know it's going to be like maybe a hot mess. So I'll definitely give it a try then. It may be good with a primer, but again, my expectations with a foundation that is specifically made for oily skin would be that it would be matte and just set in place. So if you dolls have any experience with the Urban Decay you know, all-nighter foundation, then let me know what your experience is. I would love to hear your feedback. I am going to just go ahead and like blot or set again, reset this with my MAC mineralized skin finish powder, and just to take the shine out. So let me know what your feedback is on this foundation. I actually went to the MAC store today while I was out shopping, and I debated on getting a new Studio Fix foundation in NW45, and I had it in my hand. I was about to check out with it, and I was like, well, I kind of like this foundation though. Like, I like the formula of this Urban Decay foundation, to where when I get ready to repurchase, since I think that one was $40 and the MAC Studio Fix was $38, So Studio Fix Fluid was 38. So I was like, well, it's about the same price point. Do I want to repurchase the Urban Decay or do I want to go back to MAC? Now the comparison there is that the MAC Studio Fix foundation wore a little more oily on my skin. And you know, I used to get a lot of shine with that where I would definitely have to set it. And then in the summertime, I would have to prime with like my Milk of Magnesia underneath in order to keep it, you know, dry or whatever. But it's really, really pretty. I like the way it feels on the skin and the way that it wears on my skin. But then I had got to thinking about how it was like kind of oily or got oily on me, that MAC. So yeah, but then that's why I didn't buy it, repurchase it today, because I didn't want to get it. But then I thought, well, if this is going to be wearing oily just the same, the Urban Decay, then now it becomes a toss-up. But at least with the Urban Decay, it dries matte. It's like, you know, more of a matte finish on it. So at least goes like that. And I think the Studio Fix, whenever I wore it, it had more of a, like a sheen or a, more of a natural finish to where it had a little, like, you know, something to it where it wasn't like a dry or matte finish. Not terrible, but it's just not what I was thinking it was gonna be, where it was just gonna be like bulletproof, sweatproof, oilproof for, you know, the day, especially when it got into hot weather. So we'll see. Comment below and let me know you guys' feedback on that. But yes, my face, my skin is so annoying, you guys. Like, I hate this breakout here. To me, it just like really throws off my whole look, my whole like makeup and everything. I did not end up putting on a different lip, you know, after I went to eat earlier. I just kind of been flowing with it. I didn't put on a lip or anything because I was outside and I just didn't feel like it. So yeah, I know that my skin is having a breakout because, like I said, that primer there, I think that's what it is. It just kind of seems like it smothers my skin when I put the primer underneath and no air is flowing, so it just like causes everything to just stick in there, I think. And so for that reason, I think it causes me to have breakouts whenever I do try to wear a primer or whatever. But then also, I know lately I have been so stressed. I've been super stressed. I've been eating terribly, just eating whatever. Like for lunch, I just had like fried chicken, waffles, grits. And then I backdoored and had two scoops at Baskin Robbins with an ice cream cone and whipped cream. Last night I ate bad, like Whataburger, just fast food, just bad stuff. I haven't been drinking my water like I usually do and everything. So I know that has a lot to do with it, along with stress and stuff like that. So, you know, expectations for my skin. And I've been sleeping in my makeup lately. Like, I've been so super lazy. I haven't even been doing like my wipes, which is just the, like my makeup removing wipes, which is just the minimum, like a bare minimum. When I'm just dead ass tired for bed, I used to be really good about at least going in with a makeup wipe and just at least taking the makeup off. But I haven't even been doing that lately, you guys. I've just been like full face makeup, go to sleep. Horrible, I know. So I have nobody else to blame but myself for this skin and these breakouts. Hey, I just wanted to come back and show you guys. I set my makeup with my powder and this is how it's looking. So it's not oily anymore. The breakout to me kind of makes my skin look oily to me. Like, it just screams like not good for some reason. It just makes me feel flawed, which is crazy because it's nothing but a pimple, but it just makes it, to me, I just hate it. So anyways, I do really, really like good skincare. I always tell you dolls this, and I think the key to flawless makeup and just like a really polished and perfect look is to have flawless skin. So that's why I'm always such a big proponent of skincare, because it really, really does make a difference in your look. Because to me, that just looks like not all the way there. Like, it's good, but it's not what it needs to be, in my opinion, in my face. So I'm gonna work on that. Let me know if you've tried the Mario Badescu, the drying cream, not the pink one but the green one, and if it worked for you. I think it's called like a buffering cream, if I'm not mistaken. Hey dolls, it's your girl, and I just wanted to hop on here really quick. It is Friday. I'm getting ready to hang out with some of my girlfriends, some new friends, which is cool. I love new friends and everything like that, and they like to hang out and get together just like me, so that's already a good match. With this hair, dolls, let's get into it really fully. Let me take my seatbelt off and hopefully it doesn't start hollering at us, but this is it. I'm in a red lip as always. I'm in a two-piece set. It's pants and it's got like this crop top with the little like faux neck or whatever, the mock neck, which is cute. And then it's just the pants, and the pants are kind of bell bottom on the bottom. It's all black, so I wanted to throw on just a bright lip. And there's my seatbelt notification. Yeah, so I'm just hanging out for a girls' night tonight. We are going to grab some drinks, like, from the store, bring some wine and champagne and stuff. And then one of my friends is going to be making, like, appetizers. And we're just going to kind of hang and girl talk and stuff, because we always work. We work together, so we're always at work and can't really, you know, talk, like, on a personal level. So it's exciting to be able to hang out with these dolls tonight. I cannot wait. It's just a couple of hours. She said, what are y'all doing? Do I take it or not? Okay, never mind.
How's your place, you know?